Hello my dear children, how are you all? I hope that you all are fine and doing great at your home. Welcome back to your online class. This is your subject teacher of English from Alpine Public School situated Golabachar, Gorakhpur. Student, today's video, we're going to start the next poem which is given in your new GEMS English Reader book. So for that you all take out your English Reader book and open the next poem. The name of this poem is Homework. So student, today we will start the next poem, Homework. Okay? Student, this poem is written by Ron Mandrick. Okay? The poet of this poem is Ron Mandrick. And we have to start this poem. So without wasting any time, let's start the reading of this poem. So I'll do my homework tomorrow. I complete in a flash. Okay, first line is I'll do my homework tomorrow. I'll complete in a flash. I'm going swimming now. Ma, you should see my splash. After that, that night when I was sleeping, I saw a shadow loom. It towered tall before me in a corner of my room. And so I made a dash for it and raced right up the stairs, jumping over footstools and toppling over chairs. What utter pandemonium, what terror and pure fright, as that awful shadow chased me in the darkness of the night. I am your undone homework, it shouted in a shriek. You shouldn't have had me done, at least before last week. After that, next stage, it chased me round the garden through a mystery grey wet fog, the nasty horrid homework it went and at my dog. I bounded right out of my bed and did my homework well that day, and now I do my homework before it's time to play. Okay student, so in this poem, the poet tells about a small child like you all who keeps postponing to complete in his homework and later gets scared from horrible dream and he learns to complete his work on time. In this poem, we have to learn that how did a little boy who was very lazy and he didn't work his homework, so how the homework which is not completed by the boy get scared from horrible dream and they learn to complete his work on time. So we have to read the poem. So in the first line, in first para, we have to learn that I'll do my homework tomorrow, I'll complete it in flash. I am going swimming now, ma, you should see my splash. So in the first para, you have to see this student always postponing their homework, schoolwork for later. So in this poem also, a child postponing his homework, and in this poem you can see there is a boy who is not completed his work. So the poet says that the little child gave an excuse to his mother that he will complete his homework quickly but tomorrow. But in the present, he wants to go for swimming and wants his mother to see him splashing in the water. So student, here is the word splash. Do you know the meaning of splash? So splash is the sound of water when someone jumps into the water. Here you can see the word splash, and the meaning of splash is sound of water when someone jumps into the water. Okay, so now moving to the next stanza. In next para, we have to learn that night when I was sleeping, I saw a shadow loom. It towered tall before in a corner of my room. So in the second stanza, the little child saw a large shadow in his room. So, as you all see that here is a shadow of homework. So that time the little child becomes very frightened. And so now the third stanza, we have to learn that. And so I made a desperate and raced right up the stairs, jumping over footstool and toppling over chairs. So the child saw the shadow. He quickly ran behind it and went very fast up the stairs. As he was running, he jumped over the stool and kept falling over the chairs. Okay, so now moving to the next stanza. So next stanza, stanza 4. What utter pandemonium, okay, pandemonium. What terror and pure fright as that awful shadow chased me in the darkness of the night. So in fourth stanza, we have to learn that as the black shadow started chasing the child in the darkness of night, the child in poem get frightened and scared and scene become very noisy. So now the next number, fifth stanza. I'm your undone homework, it shouted in a shriek, and you should have had me done at least before last week. The shadow said to the child that I am your undone homework. I am your undone homework. It shouted in a shriek. You should have had me done at least before last week. So in this stanza, the shadow shouted that it is his undone homework. The shadow exclaimed that it is his incomplete work. He shouted he should have to complete his homework along before at least week before. Okay, at least last week before last week. The incomplete homework said to the child that you have to complete me. Okay, so now moving to the next in six. Stanza 6, we have to read that it chased me round the garden through a misty grey with fog. That nasty horrid homework, it went and at my dog. In next stanza, we have to read that it chased me round the garden through a misty grey with fog. That nasty horrid homework, it went and at my dog. So, student, in this stanza, the shadow followed him round the garden through a undergrowth wheat fog. That very bad, horrible homework, what did it do? It went and ate my dog. The little boy said, the child said that the black shadow is chasing me and through a misty grey wheat fog and the nasty, here is the word nasty. Do you know what the meaning of nasty? It means very bad. So that shadow was very bad, horrid homework. It went and ate my dog. Okay, so now in the last, I bounded right out of my bed and did my homework well that day. And now I do my homework before it's time to play. So now after that horrible dream, the child, in the last stanza, the child has realized that he is complete his homework before the playing. So now after that horrible dream, the child in the poem complete his homework before going for play. It means that it was a bad and frightful dream, but at least the child realized that complete his work before time. Child should complete his or her homework before going to play, watching television or going out for party, etc. Otherwise, the guilt of incomplete work not enjoy anything else. So, student, this is this poem for you that you always complete your work. You have to, you should complete your homework on time. And after that, you have to do whatever you want to do. Okay? Without completing your homework, you can't do anything. Okay? Firstly, you all complete your homework. And after that, you have to do whatever you want and whatever you want to say. Okay, student. So through this poem, we have to learn about the importance of homework and how to we complete our homework on the time. So student, I hope you all are enjoying this poem and you all are understood very well this poem. Okay, so till then, stay safe, stay healthy and keep reading of this poem and also learn it. And I will explain the next remaining part of this exercises in my next video. Okay student, so till then, thank you.